Hello student, in last video we have seen the physical properties of metal and non-metal, and in this video we are going to study about the chemical properties of metal. Now the first chemical properties, metals are electron donor and they form cation. Metals are electropositive. Actually metals have 1, 2 or 3 electron in their outermost shell, and these electrons are loosely held with the nucleus. So as a result, it is easy for metal to lose its electron. Now when metal loses electron, it acquires positive charge, and therefore metals are called as a electropositive. Now here examples are given, that is one first example is sodium. Okay, now sodium, the sodium atomic number is 11, and its electronic configuration is 2, 8, 1. Now in sodium, outermost electron contain 1 electron, and therefore sodium has tendency to lose 1 electron. When sodium loses 1 electron, it acquires Na plus charge. Similarly for magnesium, its electronic configuration is 2, 8, 2. When it loses, it has tendency to lose 2 electron. When magnesium loses 2 electron, it acquire Mg2 plus charge. Okay, similarly for aluminium, aluminium has atomic number 13, its electronic configuration is 2, 8, 3. It has tendency to lose 3 electron, and when it loses 3 electron, it will get Al3 plus charge. Okay, so this is the one of the property, chemical property of metal. Let's see another one. Reaction of metal with oxygen. Metal react with oxygen to form metal oxide. Okay, but all metal do not react with oxygen at the same rate. Different metal shows different reactivity towards the oxygen. Reactivity with oxygen depend on the nature of metal. For example, this metals like sodium, potassium and calcium, they are highly reactive metal and they react with oxygen even at room temperature. Whenever metal react with oxygen, it form their oxides. Now here sodium, when sodium react with oxygen, it form sodium oxide. When potassium react with oxygen, it form potassium oxide. Calcium react with oxygen, it form the calcium oxide. So whenever metal react with oxygen, it form their corresponding oxides. Now next is the metals like magnesium do not react with oxygen at room temperature. They burn in air on heating to form corresponding oxides. Okay, so oxygen, magnesium it does not react with oxygen at room temperature. To react with oxygen, we have to burn the magnesium ribbon. Okay, now here in this picture, this is the magnesium ribbon. Magnesium ribbon is burn whenever it burn with the white dazzling flame, and the residue occur. This is the residue is of for magnesium oxide. This residue is of for magnesium oxide. So magnesium ribbon burn in presence of oxygen, it form magnesium oxide. The metal like zinc react with oxygen only on strong heat. And when metal like zinc, when zinc is strong heated with oxygen, it produce zinc oxide. So this is the second property of metal, metal, that is when metal react with oxygen, it form their corresponding oxides. Now let's see the next one. Reaction of metal oxide with acid. Metal oxides are generally basic in nature. As they react with acid, it produces salt and water. Now here the example of copper oxide. When copper oxide react with HCl, it forms CuCl2 plus H2O. Now here this picture black color, this CuO, okay, copper oxide. When we added copper oxide in HCl, the color of HCl is pale yellow. Okay, when we added copper oxide, the color of HCl will change and it will be blue color. That means what? The formation of CuCl2. So that means what? Whenever copper oxide react with this HCl, it produce CuCl2 plus water. That means what? It is a CuCl2 is a salt, is a salt. Okay, CuCl2 is a salt and this is water. So when metal oxide react with water acid, it produce salt and water. But some metal oxide shows both acidic as well as basic behavior. Okay, such metal oxide react with acid as well as base to produce salt and water are called as a amphoteric oxides. Let's see the example of amphoteric oxide. Now amphoteric example of amphoteric oxide is Al2O3. Al2 aluminium oxide react in the following manner with acid and base. See, that is example, when Al2O3, when it react with acid, it produce AlCl3 plus H2O. That means what? When Al2O3, it's act as a, it shows basic nature. They are, it act as a basic oxides. Okay, now here, while here in this reaction it react with NaOH and it also form produce salt and water, here it act as a acidic oxide. Okay, so now this Al2O3, it shows both as both the behavior, that is acidic oxides as well as basic oxide. Therefore this type of this aluminium oxide, it's called as a amphoteric oxides. Now the next one is the reaction of metal oxide with water. Most of the metal oxide are insoluble in water, but some of this dissolve in water to form alkali. Sodium oxide and potassium oxide dissolve in water to produce alkali as follows. When sodium oxide react with water, it produce sodium hydroxide, and potassium oxide when react with water, it produce potassium hydroxide. That means what? The metal oxide when react with water, it produce their corresponding hydroxide. Now next property is reaction of metal with water. Metal react with water to produce metal oxide and hydrogen gas. Metal oxide that are soluble in water dissolve in water and form metal hydroxide, but all metal do not react with water. That means what? The some metals react with a cold water, whether and some water react with the hot water, or some metal do not react with the water at all. Now look at this reactivity series. In reactivity series, this potassium, sodium and calcium, these are the highly reactive metal, and this metal react with cold water, while magnesium react with hot water. Okay, and aluminium and zinc, these two metals are react with the steam, and these metals do not react with water at all. That is lead to gold, they do not react with water at all at any condition. Now let's see the reactions of different metal with water. Now let's look at here, the sodium and potassium react with water, with cold water, to form corresponding respective hydroxide and hydrogen gas. Okay, the reaction is so violent, and it produces hydrogen gas and it catches fire. For example, here reaction is given, the sodium when react with water, it produces sodium hydroxide and hydrogen gas, and potassium when react with the water, it produces potassium hydroxide and hydrogen gas. That means when potassium and sodium, when it react with water, it catch fire. Why it catch fire? Because it is a this reaction is exothermic reaction, and large amount of heat is liberated, and this heat, this much heat is enough for hydrogen gas to catch fire. Now metals such as potassium and sodium are highly reactive metals, and they catch fire when it kept open. Why this question may be asked in board exam, why sodium and potassium is kept open? Because they are highly reactive metal, and it catch fire when we kept it in a open space. Why it is so? Because it catch the, it react with the moisture present in the atmosphere, and it catches fire. Therefore this potassium and sodium are kept immersed in a kerosene oil. Now next is the calcium. As I told you, calcium react with cold water, but this reaction is not so violent. Okay, here also it is also exothermic reaction, but it does not catch fire. When calcium react with water, it produces calcium hydroxide. Now here magnesium, as I told you, magnesium do not react with cold water, but it react with hot water, hot boiling water, and it form its corresponding hydroxide. When magnesium react with hot water, it produce magnesium hydroxide and hydrogen gas. Now metal like zinc and aluminium, they do react with steam, and it produce their oxides and hydrogen gas. That is zinc when react with water, that is steam. Here I have put G. D means what? The water is in gaseous state, that is steam. When zinc react with the steam, it produce zinc oxide and hydrogen gas. When aluminium react with the steam, it produce aluminium oxide and hydrogen gas. Now here in this picture, this metal is a zinc metal, and here in this in that test tube, the cotton plug is there, which is soaked with water. When we heat this test tube, the vapor from this cotton plug will come out and it react with this zinc, and the formation of zinc oxide takes place, and here this is the outlet for the hydrogen gas. Now, reaction of metal with dilute acid. Sodium, magnesium and calcium, they react violently with the hydrochloric acid and dilute sulfuric acid liberated hydrogen gas and metal salt. Okay, now this here also, when sodium, potassium and calcium, when they react with dilute HCl or dilute H2SO4, it catch fire. Now here sodium, they when sodium react with the HCl, it produce NaCl and hydrogen gas, and when sodium react with H2SO4, it produce Na2SO4 and hydrogen gas. Now next is the reactivity series. Here the reactivity series, in this reactivity series the list of metal is arranged in order to their decreasing activity after performing displacement experiment of the following series, known as the reactivity or activity series. See, these are the reactivity series. In this reaction, as I before also I told you, with this element which are above in the reactivity series are the most reactive element, while the element which are below the reactivity series are least reactive element. Now next is the reaction of aluminium and zinc with the dilute H2SO4 and H2SO4. When aluminium and zinc react with dilute H2SO4 and HCl, it liberate hydrogen gas and corresponding metal salt. Look at here, when we place zinc in H2SO4, then bubbles of hydrogen gas is coming out. So these are, in this picture, this is the reaction of zinc with the dilute H2SO4. Such kind of observation we can observe over there. Now here, when aluminium react with the 6HCl, that is HCl, you will get the AlCl3 and hydrogen gas. When aluminium react with the H2SO4, we get Al2SO4 twice plus 3H2O. When zinc react with the HCl, we will get Zn chloride, zinc chloride and hydrogen gas. And when zinc react with H2SO4, then it produce Zn sulfate and H2 hydrogen gas. Now iron reacted slowly with dilute HCl and H2SO4. When iron react with HCl, it produce FeCl2, that is corresponding salt and hydrogen gas. But while copper do not react with this acid, copper do not react with HCl as well as H2SO4. Now here some metals do not react with HNO3, means in dilute HNO3 it does not liberate hydrogen gas. This is also very important question, why dilute nitric acid does not liberate hydrogen gas, because nitric acid is a strong oxidizing agent and it oxidizes the hydrogen produced and it converted it into water, and therefore it does not produce hydrogen gas. Now only two metals are there, that is magnesium and manganese. These are the two metals which react with the dilute HNO3 and produce H2 gas, while other metals do not produce H2 gas when react with the HNO3, that is nitric.